So then you can, let's say you are convinced that this looks good, but you still will want to test send it to you or a coworker just to make sure it looks good before you send it out to all of your leads. So you can send it in here, let's say to my email. And then you're gonna see it on your inbox, and you'll get to see how it looks, what's the title, and what's actually showing. So then after you make sure this looks good, then you can go live. And the reason for this is when you save, you're gonna have all of the changes you made. So you know, if you need to go do something else, you can save it and come back to this later. But until you make it go live here, you're not going to be able to send over, so you won't see it in the next step that I'm going to show you. So in here, you're going to go live. Now you're not sending your email campaign just yet, so this is good to save, and then you're going to be able to make some more changes. You would just have to stop it here. Or if you edit it, it's gonna tell you it's live, and then yeah, it's gonna stop it for you, and you can make changes here. So don't panic. You can go live here, and it's not gonna send it over just yet. Here in the summary, you can change some stuff here. So you can change where the address this will come from. So this is a default one. But I can make it look better, and I can just use my email address so it looks better on, or it looks more trustworthy in their inboxes, and I can input my name in here. Or let's say if you want to send an internal communication maybe, or something from your boss, I would be able to change it in here. So again, you can save. Gonna always check for errors. And then if you go out here, then you're gonna see it here, and you're gonna see here it's live. So all of these that say live, you're gonna see them in the next step, and for those that say draft, then you wouldn't be able to see them. So the next step, it's going to be your customer journey. So you will want to go in here, customer journeys, and you will have to create one in order to send your email campaign. So you would go in here, and this is kind of where it all comes together. So you come in here again. You always have the option to create a new one in here. It's gonna ask you if you want to use a template. So in this case, I can actually skip it. And you can do it here from scratch. So it's going to ask you to set your audience, and this is where you need to have created your segments. This is the reason why, because you can't just choose one by one here. So in this, you have a different set of options here. In this scenario, you're going to have your segments. You're going to select a segment. And then you're gonna look for it in here. So for us, let's say I want to send over to this segment here, or let's see if rather I have a dynamics one. So in here this is going to be another video again. But in here, we created a dynamic segment that includes people that have clicked on any of our Dynamics 365 links whenever we send out email campaigns. So we know for a fact these people are interested, because they not only did they receive the email and they opened it, but they also clicked on a link that contained Dynamics 365 information. So this is a good segment to send this information to, because they're already interested in this. So now I'm selecting my segment here, and there's a set of options you can select here. You can just say send an email. You can choose one of these options. So let's say you want to say you can say send an email, and then you choose your email. For us, it's going to be the one that we just created. So this list here, we only get those marketing emails we created that are live. The ones that are still draft won't show in here. So that's why you need to go live. So then you get to select it here, and then you can create another options here. Let's say you have to select the email here, and then let's say we want to make sure we're not emailing any email addresses that are not actually receiving our emails. So maybe we're emailing someone that's no longer working in there, or an email that's no longer active, right? So then we can say, if I send an email to any hire bounces, then if the option is yes, then I want to run this workflow here. And this is something we previously set up, so that's going to be another video again. But we can select it here. So one of our workflows, it's going to be deactivate this contact, because we don't want to keep emailing them if it's going to keep bouncing. So this is a very basic one. You can a very basic customer journey you can create. So you're going to have your email, you're going to send it over, and then if it bounces, you're going to deactivate that contact, and if it doesn't, then you just end it. You could choose another option here. If it does, then create a lead. If you don't have it for some reason already created in your CRM, you can redirect them to a marketing forum or page, but this is a very basic set you can choose for now. Then you're going to save it. It's always going to check if there are any errors in what you're setting up. And then again, you can change here, you can change the name, which is going to make it way easier for you down the road when you're trying to identify which journey this is within all of the ones you've created. So I can just have a related name here, so boost productivity, let's see. So you save it, and then you go in here, and this is where you are going to select when your email is going to be sent out. So in here, you have to make sure you choose the right time. And in here, this is very important because you have to select the time zone. So like for us, it would be Central Time. So you would have it somewhere in here. So you have Pacific Time, Central Time, etc. So let's say I want to send it out in Pacific Time, and then you select it in here. Maybe you want this to go out, let's say starting 9 a.m. Pacific Time, so it's not so early, or more like 7 a.m. here, so in the East Coast it's going to be there 10 a.m. Maybe you want to do that. Whatever makes sense for you and your marketing goals is what you're going to select here. And then maybe you just don't want it to be sending all day. So you can select an ending time here. Again, whatever makes sense for you. You're going to save it. And then what you're going to do is you're going to go live. So once you go live in here, this is the step. This is the final step. So after you go live here, again, you can always come back and edit, but now you're really setting it up to go out. So in here, once I go live, I'm telling this, you know, let's say tomorrow or a Monday, which would make more sense. Let's send this campaign out. At 7 a.m. So whatever I do before that, I can still come back and edit, and it's gonna save. And then if it's after that, then I can still make the changes, but you are probably already, you probably already had some emails that have gone out. So again, this is where it all comes together. So you have your segments that you created based off your contacts. Then you create your marketing email, and then you go to the customer journey section, and this is where you select the marketing email you just created, and then you select the segment you just created as well. And you just set it up here in the way you, that makes sense for your marketing goals and for your campaign goals. You set it up in here for it to go out.